Hello everyone, we are back with a new video and today I am going to show you how we make a ESP32 drone from scratch. I have been selling this drone from past 6 months and we have sold over 50 orders yet. And so many people were asking how you solder and assemble the drone. So this is going to be a tutorial for the users who want to make their own drone. So continue watching the video and you will see how we make the drone from scratch and fly it in the air. After successfully applying the solder paste, now we need to place the components according to the schematic. So all the schematic files will be given in the description, so you can refer that. Now we will be using our DIY Reflow hot plate for soldering the ESP32 drone. So I have set the temperature and as you can see I have placed the PCB and it started soldering on its own. After successful soldering, it's time to assemble the PCB. So we separate the legs and attach them as you see in the video. Now we fix the rubber grommets inside this gap so that we can fix the 720 cordless motor inside this. And it helps in avoiding the vibrations and holds the motor really tight. Now this is an optional process, but I recommend you to follow this because this ensures that the legs are tightly packed and doesn't move after falling from the height. So these are our 720 cordless motor, which comes in pair of two. Two are anti-clockwise and two are clockwise. So we will insert the motors inside the grommets and you can see it fits in really tight. Now we solder the motor wires on the PCB. Make sure you place the wires in right polarity so the drone motors spin in a particular direction. So you need to follow the same wiring as I'm showing in this video. These are our 55mm propellers which will go on our 720 cordless motor. This also has two pairs labeled as A and B, so they should also go on the motors in a specific pattern. So follow the video and assemble it in the same manner. Now let's connect a 2-pin male header on the PCB so that we can insert the battery wires into it. Drone is fully assembled. Now let's program it. So press the boot button and insert the USB cable. To program ESP32 drone, we need ESP IDF 4.4.8. So you can see this is how it looks. So after opening it, we will put it in the background and I will show you two commands. This command is for locating the program files. So let's locate the files, go in the firmware inside ESP drone, and here is the location of the program. So we use the same location here. Your location may be different. And second command is for programming the ESP32 drone. So we need to find the COM port on which our drone is connected. So we will go inside device manager, and here you can see our drone is connected on COM4. So here you can see we have selected COM4. You can change according to your needs. So let's copy the first command and paste it inside the ESP IDF 4.4.8 and press enter. After that, let's copy second command which will program our ESP32 drone. So let's paste it here, you can see, and now we will press enter. So this will start programming our ESP32 drone. If you are trying this for first time, it will take like 5 minutes or 2 minutes to compile the program, and after that it will work instantly like this. So you can see I have successfully uploaded the code, and now we'll press the reset button given here, and you can see the 3 LEDs on the right side will start blinking one by one. So the code is uploaded successfully. Now we will insert the battery and place under the drone. So connect the battery to the drone and make sure you are placing the drone on the flat surface for its own calibration. After starting, it will check the propellers, and now it's ready to fly. To fly the drone, first of all, connect to the ESP drone AP mode, in which you need to enter the password from 128. It will be only needed for first time. After that, you open the ESP drone app, and on the right side, you see two arrows. Click on that, and after that, it will ask for location permission. Give access to location and come back to the app. After that, click again and it will connect to the ESP drone. And now you can control the ESP32 based drone with your mobile phone. The app is available for Android and Apple devices. So these are some settings which I customized for my specific drone. For your own drone, you need to change the settings.